a lot of things with him. You sat with him on his couch. You sat with him in his car. You were with him where nobody else was, even when he didn't wear his vest. And you asked him a couple of questions, like these questions.
Speech loss. Terror. Yes. The best. The worst. Wrong. A vehicle. I love it. I hate it. Respect. Fantastic. Too many. Worst thing ever. I like it. Why not? Yes. No. Sure. One word? Well, not enough, two words. Insufficient. Bright.
He seems relaxed. Was he during your 4 months?
I think he's a pretty relaxed guy. He's been a politician for 20 years. He knows what he's doing. He has one core message that he tends to repeat quite frequently. So he knows his talking points quite well. So I think he's more relaxed than probably the rest of the world would think he could be.
How do you think you made it for the international market, of course, not for the Netherlands. But do you have any idea how we in Holland would perceive it, the documentary you made and the things you show us? Maybe we don't know.
Sure. That is correct. That originally we thought, okay, we should make this movie for the international stage.
Yeah.
We were shocked when Brexit happened. We were double shocked when Trump was elected. And we thought, okay, where could this happen next? That was our mindset. And that was why our team decided to pack our bags and come to the Netherlands originally. We thought, Where could this Trump effect happen next? And we thought the Netherlands might. At that time, Wilders was first place in the polls. He was at the top of the polls. They thought he was going to get 36 seats at that stage. So we thought there was a really good chance that that number could even go up by the time the election happened. So we really thought that he could come in first. As it turned out, he came in second. But hey, still a pretty impressive performance.
And did you have any restrictions when you were making it? Did you?
The only restriction that he asked us was, can you please not speak with my family? And we respected that because we didn't have an intention to speak with his family. If we had an intention to speak with his family, then maybe we would have tried to negotiate that. But we didn't have an intention. It wasn't part of our initial architecture for the film. So it was fine with us.
And he liked you. Yes, he did.
Hey, I wish more people liked me, but you know.
Did you like him as a person, beside his ideas?
As a person, he's a human. That's what I really want people to understand. That.
But did you like him?
He's flawed.
The silence is killing.
If you want to look at my Twitter, you can see where I lie on the political spectrum, which is not to the far right.
No, but those things are his ideas. There's the human being.
As a person,
as a person.
I have a beer with him in a pub? Yes, I would have a beer with him in a pub, absolutely. I think he, when he's not talking about Islam, can be a very funny, charming guy.
Hmm. Yeah, I say it because in the trailer he talks about you and about the way you work, and he's really positive about you.
I never spoke to one journalist or filmmaker. For me, I'm in politics for a long time, and for me it's the first time. So I discussed issues that I've never discussed with anybody before. I shared pictures of my dear mother and wife, and I walked with you through parks and had you in my car. What never ever happened in the whole time that I'm a parliamentarian, certainly not in the long time, more than a decade now that I'm under 24/7 police protection. So, I cannot imagine that there is another thing that we didn't discuss. I was very open. We spoke almost about everything. You said every day and every interview 500 times, this is the last question. And then 20 followed all the time again. So, no, I think we did. I gave you a fair deal.